Hello friends, myself Mr. Sunil Devkar, Head Department of English of Rao Bahadur Narayan Rao Boroke College, Srirampur. Today I am going to deal with the topic Tips of Effective Communication. Already I have dealt with what is communication, what are the different types of communication, what is the difference between verbal and non-verbal communication, what are the different modes which we use in communication. So today I am going to deal with what are the effective tips which we can make in an effective communication. So effective communication is a part of our personality. So it plays around 40%. The role of communication, whenever you are communicating, the role of that communication is around 40%. How you speak? We say first impression is the last impression. Whenever you meet any person, so that means communication, it is not only just speaking. It starts the way in which you, that means your physical appearance, the way in which you dress, the way in which you make your hairstyle, the way in which you walk, the way in which you communicate with people in the society. And at the same time, two things that are important. Whatever you speak, it should be reflected in your action. It should be reflected in your commitment. So that means there should be honesty in our communication. At one side, some people, they just speak. They just give different kinds of, we can say, in their speeches, they give, that means I will do such and such things. But in reality, the work is not at all done. So there is a communication gap. And what are the different barriers? So when we try to overcome these barriers, they are communicated by our own selves. So we should overcome those barriers. And I would say the greatest threat, it is what? There is a mismatch between your word and your action, or your thought and your action. So whatever is your idea or thought, it should be reflected in your action. Then only the communication, it can be completed in a proper manner. So that is, you can say, so how, what are the different barriers, and at the same time, how you can overcome those barriers and you can become an efficient person, a good communicator, and a different kind of identity, it would be naturally reflected through your communication. So what are the general different barriers in communication? So barriers, they may slow down your communication. So here, in a sense, likewise, here in this classroom, when I take this example, so I am giving a presentation, so I should come out with a proper plan. I should not be a failure. So whenever I am presenting here, I should see, yes, I should be well prepared. What is my topic? To whom I am going to address? What kind of language I should use? So who are the listeners? Yes, these listeners, they are the college students, or they might be some other faculties. So this is a formal communication or informal communication. What kind of language I should use here? So all those plans, they should be fit in my mind. So I should overcome those barriers. And here, whenever I come here in the classroom, I should see that there should be no voice barrier. So that means there should be no electricity failure. I should switch off my phone. It should not disturb me. So that means whatever the notes I am going to take, they should be in a proper manner. So there should be a proper title, the sub points and the presentation. It should be logical with proper introduction and conclusion. So if you plan in this manner, you can overcome those barriers. So those barriers we should try to overcome. You should try to overcome, that means where I am going to go, where, that means at what time is my presentation. So I should be in time, not on time. If you are in time, all the problems can be settled in a proper manner. If you are late, everything would be, it would be problematic. So that means you should make a plan itself. That means what kind of presentation I am going to make, or you can, presentation is just one side, but it is, we are speaking about communication. So that means communication, it should be in a proper manner. You should not speak a vulgar language. So whenever you can say there should be, that means knowledge is at one side. Yes, you are a knowledgeable person, that is at one side. That is your hard skill, I would say. That is your technical skill, that is your job skill. But at the other side, what is important? These soft skills, or you may say life skills, they play a violent role. They play an important role. And if that means, I would say that is the humanistic approach. That is the humanistic approach. And one side, it is your knowledge. And when these two things, they come together, you can become an effective communicator. So that we should make a clear-cut balance. Knowledge is not everything. Knowledge is your certificate, is your technical skill. But the application, while making that application, you have to walk in this world. And whenever you are walking in this world, everything, it cannot be as per your vision. You have to be flexible. You have to change according to the people you meet in the society. So whenever you meet the different people in the society, their approaches, their attitudes, it should be known to you. Yes, if I am speaking in my local place, I am quite familiar. But if I am going in any metropolitan city, the people around me, they might be different. So I may not find easy to adjust. So I should find out what are the different barriers where I could come across. There might be language barriers. I would say, even though my mother tongue is Marathi, but itself, the Marathi language, it changes after every 60 kilometers. It changes after every 60 kilometers. Here, in a sense, I would say, in Nagar, we may call it as Nagri Marathi. If you go in Kolhapur, the language is different. If you go in Konkan region, it is different. Khandesh, it is different. In Vidarbha, it is different. So, at some time, that means the same word, it is used in a different manner, the tone, it is different. You might feel that language abrupt, in case of, we can say, Satara or Kolhapur region. But if you go in Konkan region, they are soft-spoken people. So that means the tone, it depends upon the environment, where you are brought up, or in what surrounding you are brought up. But that means what kind of, you can say, your personality has been reflected from your background. So where you are brought up, that means it is reflected through your work culture, your words. So those also, they play a significant role. So we should be, that means we should try to judge. So we should try to judge, and we should say, that means be the change. Be the change according to the prevailing situation. If you change, you will feel comfortable. If you are adamant, if you are not ready to change, likewise, you cannot adapt with the prevailing situation. And that's why people, they run away from the reality and they become a failure. So those things, we should, this such kind of many different barriers, we should try to overcome those barriers. Next, if you are a complete human with all these skills, it will naturally help you where? It will help you in your professional world, or in the job market, or even in a businessman. If you see a shopkeeper, I would say, generally we see many Maharashtrian people. I'm sorry to say, but we say nowadays they are cautious. But what is a specific specialty? What kind of work do you really know? Or you can say, if you see South Indian people, you can say, that means that Anna, they are across all the different corners of the world. Even the Punjabis, they are knowledgeable person. Even though we may create humor on them, but they take it positively. They take it positively, they accept it. But and at the same time, they likewise, they trust in their work, I would say. Every person, or every, you can say, India itself is a multicultural land. It is a multicultural land. There are n number of languages, more than 750 n number of languages they are spoken in India. Regional languages, they are 18. But at the same time, every part, different language. Many languages, they even don't have their scripts, you can say. They don't have their scripts, but they are spoken. They are spoken. So we should try to know the people, know the culture. I would say knowing people is a research. Knowing people is a research, and how you adjust with them and how you communicate with them, it is again, that means it will create much more interest. I would say it is understanding people is an innovative work. It is an innovative work. It is a creative work. And it is, that means it will give you happiness. It will give you happiness. And I would say our attitude, it should be a challenging attitude at different level. I would say instead of working a routine work, we should try to accept different challenges every day and try to say that, yes, something new I have done. If we develop that attitude, it will surely give you happiness. Your work style, it would be changed. And you can say your routine work, it will also help you to come out. That means something new you are doing. That attitude, it should be developed in us, and which will help you to make a good progress. And you can become a good professional, in a professional and in the job market. Next, I will give you some clips, tips. What are the different tips which we should remember? How you can overcome in good communication? So generally, what do we see? That means communication, it is not only oral communication. Written, if you see, many companies, they demand handwritten application. They don't give you printed application. They demand what? Handwritten application. It might be of any job or manager. What do they see? Whenever an application, it has been demanded in handwritten, we should know they are testing you. What has been tested in handwritten application? Your written skills. What are your written skills? What words you use, your vocabulary power, your way of presentation, how you write your language, that means, are you a soft spoken person or are you a rude person? It is reflected. So that means your way of presentation, your humbleness, your politeness, it has been reflected in written communication, I would say. So written communication is the first step of your, that means your application letter itself is the first step of the entry in your job. Your application, it reflects, it can change the attitude of the people. If you are sending, that means our words, they should be soft. They can change the people. So that's why we say words have power. Use them properly. So words are proper. If you start giving bad words, it is much more destructive rather than beating a certain person. Physical can say torture, it can be beard, but torture of words, it cannot be beard by people. It is lifelong. People will not forget those things. So words we should use properly, language we should use properly. So avoid spelling mistakes, use correct language. So language, I would not say, that means using correct languages means what? I would say, who is a good speaker? One who is able to communicate in a simple way. One who is able to present in a simple manner, that person is a successful person, I would say. So presenting in a simple language, that means the listeners or the audience, they should be easily able to apprehend you. They should be able to understand you. That person is an intellectual person, I would say. That person naturally, he has developed a rapport between the speaker and the audience. So your speech, it should always be goal-oriented communication. So whenever you are speaking, so that means there should be certain goal, there should be certain destination. And how we can achieve that destination? It should be in a well-projected manner. So whenever we are communicating, it should be goal-oriented communication. So whatever the goal, by the end of the day, what work I am going, that means I have to complete. That is my goal, today's goal. What is my midterm goal? By the end of this month, what I want to do? So that means that it can become your midterm goal. What is your long-term goal? It might be yearly, 3 year, 5 year. So it might be your vision. So we should be able to define your goal in a proper manner. And after defining your goal, that means how you, that it reflects in your communication. Then next, good interpersonal relation. Interpersonal. Without that, that means all these points are interconnected to each other. Interpersonal. So the personals to whom, whichever you are working, it might be inside and outside the company, or inside and or outside the institution, whatever kind of institution, it might be educational institute, it might be any different institute, wherever you are working. So within your employees, inward and outward, that means they might be the government departments, the public, the customers, or whosoever, you can say, you might come across. So likewise, the interpersonal relations, they should be maintained healthy. Wherever the chain, if it breaks, it becomes a failure. A work which can be done within a day, it might take month, or it might even take year, or it might not even be completed. So it would be destructive. Communication, good communication, it will surely help to your success. So communication is what success. Communication is happiness, I would say. And it, so that means it will help to develop your interpersonal skills. So next, be effective listener. This is also very important, I would say. Some people, they are not ready to listen to others. Everyone, he should be able to distinguish. That means he should be a good listener. That means you should be able to distinguish. That means no person is of low grade. You should treat every person that as a human. You should treat them as a human, and you should listen to them. That even a small problem, it can be resolved. We can give n number of examples there also. There are n number of stories also. Good listener, he will always be a success. He will always be successful. It makes us to introspect. It makes, that means a listener, he can resolve many problems. If you listen others, some people, they speak less and they listen more. Or you can say listen is what? Listening is an input skill. It is input. It is an input, and it will help you develop our knowledge. It is just like reading. Reading and listening, these are the inputs which enhances our knowledge. And so that ability, it should be developed in us. So whenever the speaker is speaking, let him speak. And at that time, whatever difficulties you have, you may write it on the paper. And when the listener, he completes his speech, you may ask him the questions, or you may get your difficulties resolved. So a good listener will also be a good communicator, I would say. Then verbal messages with proper non-verbal codes. So verbal messages, verbally, yes, written and oral, that is your verbal communication. But your non-verbal, it reflects your communication. So non-verbal, how you, that means, as I already told you, your appearance, your dressings, then next, your facial expressions. Your facial expressions, what are your facial expressions? That means your face, it should not be fearful. It should be amicable. It should be pleasing. That means wherever you go, people should come close to you, and at the same time, the difficulties, it should be resolved, you can see. Then next, your eye contact. You should maintain a proper eye contact. Whenever you are speaking, your eye contact, what does it reflect? It reflects your confidence. Whenever you are speaking with your colleagues or your boss or wherever you go, well, that means your confidence is reflected through your eye contact. Look above shoulder level. So it will help you. That means whenever you look, maintain a proper eye contact, it shows your confidence. Your postures, how you sit, how you walk, your postures, your gestures, they also reflect, you can say. So non-verbal, it also plays a significant role in your effective communication. Further, I would say, what is it? Wherever you are communicating, make it a creative process. I would say, if you can say a primary teacher, if he is a primary teacher, if he is an English teacher, likewise, you should try to adopt different techniques. So an example of a primary teacher. So if he might be a nursery teacher. He is teaching ABCDs, 26 alphabets to the students. So likewise, how you teach them, he can say. So likewise, we whenever we start our teaching with what? We learn language through images initially. Any language, it is learned to what? Through images. A kid, a small kid, he starts learning language through images, I would say. And so how he learns? So if you are teaching ABCD, so we cannot directly start ABCDEFG. So we say A for apple, B for ball, C for cat. So here in a sense, you may teach that you can say A for apple, the image it comes. So you may show the picture, yes, A for apple. So naturally that pupil, he starts understanding in more clear manner. So that means other than that, if the classroom students, they are feeling rather sleepy, you may tell them, that means that you may make them to stand up. And after standing up, you may say, write A in the air, A for apple, then next B, B for ball, C for cat, D for dog. Then you may also turn, that means then next you may also start, lift your right leg, then write A, B, C. What you do, it will help to what? That means your physical exercise is also been done. Then next you may also say them to write with your hip also. Physical PT teacher, you may place your hands on the hip, write A. So likewise he will say A, B. So that means you may adopt different techniques, make it much more interesting. If you make it interesting, students can understand in a different manner. So likewise, if there are you can say 30 students in the classroom, you may say A for Ajay, B for you can say Balu, C for Chintamani, so D for Divyani. So likewise, the names they may also remember. So that means different techniques they might also be adopted, and you should try to find out some creative techniques. So some games, some game techniques they should be adopted indoor and outdoor. If you facilitate, so that means it will help you. Then next, there should be positive psychological attitude. You should try to understand the psychological attitude in communication. It's very important. Whenever you are communicating with everyone, you should try to understand. That means if you are a senior, if you are an adult, you should know the difficulties of your juniors. There might be certain family problems. So why he is in that trance state? So you should try to understand everyone, and you should also take care of your of ourselves also. What are the different problems where you are failure? You might be failure in your work. You might be failure in maintaining your friendship. So why you are failure? So there might be certain reason. So you should be able to come out of this reason, and you should develop your confidence and your you can say your profession and your personal things. They should not interfere. If they interfere, naturally it would create a psychological stress, and that psychological stress, it might lead to disaster. So that it should be avoided. So it might create fear, anxiety, shyness, stress, lack of confidence. So certain examples which I have tried to give you here. So we should try to avoid these things. Then a socio-cultural barriers. So what is that? This is a very important point. Social and cultural barriers. What generally in a country like India, when we say it is multicolorful nation, but at the other side, we see there are communal riots in our country itself. We see. So people, they discriminate the people. So that means we don't treat everyone as human. So the indiscriminatory approach, it should be there. One should be impartial. You should not discriminate that he is Hindu, he is Muslim, he is Christian, he is Buddhist, he is rich, he is poor, he is boy, she is girl. So that means she is from higher class, she is from lower class. So such kind of discrimination. So this discrimination, it should be totally avoided wherever you go. If you develop this approach, it is the greatest threat. And nowadays we see many people, they are taking the support of this socio-cultural barrier. That means it has become the greatest threat. So if you distinguish people according to, that means casteism, class or gender or whatever you can say, in European countries we see there is discrimination with what? Color discrimination. But nowadays there is no such kind of discrimination. Even Barack Obama, he can become the president of America, But here we make different discrimination in a country like India, and that's why we say India is among the top unsafe countries in the world. So these things, you can say, these they have become the internal threats, and they affect in the productive work. And instead of concentrating on the productive work, we are concentrating on the destructive attitudes. So these destructive attitudes, they should be reduced, and the focus, it should be on the positive constructive work. Then it would help us to develop in a positive manner. Then next, the flow of communication, it should be proper. The messages, what generally happen? So flow of communication means what? Upward to downward. So here in any institution, likewise I will take the example of the college itself. If any message, if it has been transferred from principal to the law, that means to the pune, so it should be transferred in a proper manner. So that means the message, it should be transferred in a proper manner. The message, if there is a barrier, naturally the work, it hampers. So it hampers. So that means the principal, he might be there. Then next, afterwards, the office superintendent or registrar is there. The official staff is there. Then next, the head of departments, they might be there. The vice principals, they might be there. The faculty members, students, pupils, that lab assistants. So the work, the messages, they should be transferred in a proper manner, and the work naturally, it can be done in a proper manner. So it might be upward communication from down to up. If a message has been given by a colleague to the head of department, and the head of department, if he goes to the vice principal, and from vice principal, that message, it might go to the principal. So there is a channel. So the channel, it should function in a proper manner. And so there should be an assessment. The proper assessment, it should be there. So just, I would say, assessment, it should be on the eyes. It should not be on ears. Generally, we hear by our Chinese whisper. I have purposefully written, avoid Chinese whisper. Many people, they believe on their ears. Believe your eyes. Whatever you see by your naked eyes, that should be believed. Don't believe on the rumors. Chinese whisper, whatever the message has been transferred, at the down level, the message, it is totally transferred in a different manner. So Chinese whisper, it can become a different topic. But the message, I would say, the proper message, if it has been transferred, everything would be clear. So I would say communication, it should be visual communication. It should not be oral communication. So visual communication, whatever we see by our eyes is the truth. Eyes is the truth, and your eyes and ears, they should act in a proper manner. And that means if you believe other people, if you believe the intermediate person, then it will surely hamper the communication process, I would say. So whatever it might be, upward, downward, horizontal, horizontal means what? Between equal rank people. It is between your colleagues. And grapevine means what? Grapevine, here in a sense, there should be grapevine communication, where all people from top to bottom, they come together. You arrange these parties at intervals. So if you see in corporate world, in professional worlds, in companies, by the end of every month, what is there? The people who are doing good work, they are being rewarded. A party has been given, where all the, that means the principal or the manager, he can come to the last employee. He can also communicate with them. It is an informal communication. What is grapevine? It is an informal communication. So that grapevine or that relation, it helps us to people to come close, and there the barriers, they have been completely removed. And so that means with a new energy, people, they start working again. And if you give awards to the people who are doing work, it will surely help. So I would say that means, instead that, yes, they are the employees, try, why not give them certain share in the company also? Yes, many different companies, they are doing that. If the employee is good, that is the greatest asset of that company. If an employee is good, naturally he will help in the production of that company. So why not make him a shareholder in your company? That attitude, it should be developed. So bring him in the main channel, make him also the owner. So make him a shareholder. So he will work doubly, and the production, whatever he can say, he will help you in all different way. He will also be satisfied. So that attitude, it should be developed. And so the flow of communication, it is a significant part. Avoid Chinese whisper, I have already told you. And as lastly, preparation of presentation. Wherever you go, whatever you do, whatever aids you are going to use. So likewise, here you can say, if you are making a PowerPoint presentation, it should be in a proper manner. So what kind of font you are going to use? So there should be proper standardization. The pictures which you are going to use in your presentation, that means pictures, they also speak much more. The time of, that means you should know the time, what time you are being allotted. You should make rehearsal before going for presentation. You should make rehearsal. You should stand in front of the mirror. You should look at, that means start speaking with yourself. Make an audio of yourself. Try to listen your own audio. You can find, that means where I am lacking behind, what improvements I can do. So you can overcome and you can make it an effective presentation. So that attitude, it should be developed. And those, whatever the modes you have been utilizing at that time, so those functions, you should know the function of all those modes. And at the same time, there might be, that means there might be certain threat. If you are making PowerPoint presentation, if you go anywhere, sometime it may also happen, the light, there might be failure of light. So at that time, there should be also a hard copy of your material. So keep a standby hard copy. So your presentation, it should not break. You should be prepared. So you should know the different threats. So that means that is the best way. And always keep eyes on your head. Keeping eyes on your head means what? Be cool. Be cool. If you are cool, don't be angry person. You can say, if you are cool in your life, it will help you to communicate in a proper manner. So communication, this, that means these are the effective, that means certain tips. There are n number of tips which you can highlight. But to my level, I have analyzed certain tips. These are the important tips which can help you to become a good communicator, and it will surely help you to become a good human in your life. So that was the thing which I wanted to focus in today's presentation. Thank you.